Oh hi, I'm the Heretic. This is the question and answer video for patrons for the month of November 2018. If you would like for me to answer your questions, a Patreon donation of $1 a month gets you access to my Discord channel. Posting your question in the special patrons channel means I'll answer your questions for that month. Let's jump right in, see what you've got.
After a voluntary society is inevitably achieved, what do you think would happen to the currently widespread cultural Marxism and social justice warriorism in society? I know such a culture is perpetuated by the state and would cease growth, but do you think it would diminish?
That's a question that might actually warrant its own video. The truth is that SJWs are already a marginal phenomenon at best. I mean, yeah, they get lots of media coverage when they do show up, but it's a combination of factors that make them appear larger than they actually are. They're supported by the state and similar interest groups. George Soros-funded groups are very adept at busing massive amounts of people to, say, a protest, and when they can't do that, they hire people, both individually and through organizations like Crowds on Demand. No, really, that's a thing. So when they need to artificially inflate their numbers, and their sugar daddy Soros is perfectly willing to pick up the tab, well, don't be surprised if the protester doesn't even know the language of the sign he's holding. Mainstream media coverage will take otherwise insignificant public events and spin them to be massive demonstrations of, say, college students who are peacefully requesting that something horrible be done to someone who, 9 times out of 10, doesn't deserve it. Expect the use of weasel words and wall-to-wall coverage to make people think it's a bigger deal than it actually is. They'll show clips of people screaming with the crowd surrounding them, implying that they're surrounded by supporters, when in fact those are just ordinary people gawking at the idiocy around them. Why wouldn't they? It's hilarious. That it's funny is also the reason that alternative, conservative, libertarian media platforms will also cover them. Rush Limbaugh, websites like Campus Reform, and YouTube channels like Paul Joseph Watson, Sargon of Akkad, as well as myself, give these morons exceptional visibility. While it's almost never positive, it does raise the awareness of their existence in the public consciousness, far in excess of their actual numbers. Do they have the actual political influence to get their way? In the state of California, the UK, and Germany, yeah, absolutely. It's no secret that they can browbeat college administration into giving them what they want in college campuses around America, no matter how severely doing so is cutting into their funding with their reduced enrollees. Speaking of college campuses, the elimination of the state will kill their funding as well. So many colleges will be forced to close their doors due to their lack of funding, especially since the institutionalized model of education cannot possibly last in our world of increasing decentralization. The result will be that students who were previously taught by frequently Marxist professors about toxic ideas such as intersectionality and racial privilege in critical theory classes will cease to exist. These students, in turn, were conditioned to obey their superiors by having gone through 12-plus years of government schooling during their formative years. Government schools using the Prussian model, which was originally designed with the express purpose of squelching thought independent of government teachers. Teachers who themselves were trained and approved to teach by the state. Is it any wonder, then, that students go to a university and just assume the professor is correct because they're a professor? But most importantly, all of this is done in the name of power. The people who organize these people want power. The power to live at your expense, whether you like it or not. Now, the people who put all this together have their own agendas, which may or may not even align with the intersectional social justice agenda at all. In the complete and total absence of that power, when all social relations are voluntary, whipping people up into these frenzies to try and seize the power of the state will be utterly pointless. So yes, it will seize growth and it will diminish, as many people whipped up into this frenzy previously will either move on with their lives or they will hold on to their hatred and resentment and go on to live lonely, unhappy lives. Though as an organization, it will more likely than not be the last we ever see of them.
Do you have any hatchlings?
No, but I would like some someday. I know too much, and not passing it on to the next generation would be a crime.
Any comments on the Jews?
Jews are a species of humanoids from the Homo genus. Visually, they are difficult to tell apart from Homo sapiens, as many of their most distinguishing character traits are non-specific to them and can be found in Homo sapiens. What makes the Homo Semitic species unique in all the animal kingdom is their hive mind, of which all Homo Semitics are linked. Individual Jews lack any sort of intelligence beyond that which the hive mind mimics for the drone, which is little better than a meat puppet. This hive mind is estimated to have an IQ of around 400 and has made the complete and total eradication of the Homo sapien species its goal. Towards this end, it created central banks by which government can monopolize credit in a country. It installed its drones into several media companies to lull Homo sapiens into a false sense of security. They invented philosophies like communism to drive Homo sapiens into facilitating their own eradication, and they are responsible for the little plastic things at the end of your shoelaces called aglets, and the reason why strawberry ice cream continues to exist. Now, how do I know all this, you might be asking? Well, because I myself am a conduit of the hive mind's will. Questions? Comments? Critique? Thank you once again to my patrons. If you like what I do, become my patron through Patreon to help me spread the truth about our horribly sick society. Check it out. Even if you can't donate, sharing my video helps a lot. Even so, you can like, comment, and subscribe to become a heretic today.